Good. Our secretary has been called up by FEMA to go to Houston. She was telling us that she did this 3 times last year. And so she is, I talked to her yesterday, she was in Louisville, which is a little north of Dallas. And she finally got a break. She left here on Thursday. And registering and signing up and getting all the paperwork out of the way. And today they were going to send her, she was not sure where, but somewhere south of Dallas, to work with FEMA for the entire month of September. So she's gone. Arthea's going to be in the office this week. And then Arthea and Rod go on vacation Saturday. And I may be here by myself the following week. And when Arthea comes back from vacation, she'll be here in the office until the end of the month. And I'm looking forward to hearing periodic reports from Patty, and I'll pass them on to you as to how things are going with her work, her effort for FEMA there in the impacted areas. If you've looked at any of the videos or seen any of the news in the past week or so, you've seen all the things that have been going on that have been there to help people. And we're happy that we have people like this at NAM who, as soon as they hear the storm is coming, they're already loading up and getting ready to be there. Texas Baptist Men is probably the largest disaster relief team Southern Baptists have in the United States. And they were doing the same thing because they're there with their trucks and their people to minister to the people that need it. They're there, they set up feeding tables more than anything else, and they feed thousands of people every day from their trucks and from the food that they have in those trucks that they prepare for folks. So there's a big, massive relief effort going on. And these are people that always need our prayers, that they'll be kept safe, that the Lord will use them to minister to others, and especially, of course, to minister Christ to others and represent Christ to these people. Because many are devastated, they've lost everything except the clothes on their back, and they're thankful to be alive at that point. So do remember them in your prayers for the next many weeks as Houston dries out and as people minister and lives and communities are being rebuilt there. And be thankful for the Union Baptist Association, which is the Baptist Association in Harris County, which is where Houston is, because of the over 300 churches they have in that association. The last time I heard, they were one of the largest associations in the Southern Baptist Convention. And all of those churches are going to be serving their communities, sometimes in ways they've never served their communities before because of what has happened. So remember them in your prayers, please. Yes, sir.
And not to diminish what's happening in Fort Harvey in Texas and Louisiana, but also pray for the folks in Montana.
Yes.
The state of Montana is on fire.
Yes.
I think over 40 wildfires in Montana. They say the acreage is about the size of Rhode Island. So there's some small towns and communities in Montana that are hurt as well. So keep them in your prayers as well.
Yes. Because again, we have disaster relief people who will be in Montana. As you heard from the video, we send disaster relief teams to help and support the firefighters. And the video was talking about the teams that came to San Diego and worked in San Diego last summer. And that wagon that he was unloading is the San Diego Association's wagon. It's already here. So they don't need to drive one down from Fresno. It's already here and is used in Southern California when disaster relief teams are called up because it's got a lot of the equipment that they need. They just hook it up and off they go. But you're right about Montana. Thank you for reminding us of that. Other prayer requests you would share? Rose?
I'm sure some of you have asked me about my sister Louise that was a member here at one time. And she had to evacuate, but I talked to her day before yesterday, she's back home now at her, in her home. And her son started to her house to see how much damage she had, but the water got so high, he had to turn back, so at least Louise is home. She'll be 100 years old in November, so what an easy move for her.
Oh, no, for sure. Thank you for sharing that. And Mike did not get to move this past week from UCSD, but it looks more promising this week that he'll get to move from UCSD into his care facility. And we're glad for that. Thank you, Cass, for sharing that earlier today. Are there other prayer requests?
Yes. Pray for the Sunland Fire.
The Sunland Fire? Coming down to Burbank. Okay. Yes, it is. It did not help yesterday that we had Santa Ana winds. And we had them early this morning, but they've since turned around. So, all right, let's pray. Heavenly Father, we see these disasters around us. We have a hurricane that dumps more water than they've ever seen before in the city and environs of Houston. And then we have the wildfires that don't have enough water in Montana and in Los Angeles. Father, we pray for those who are on the front line in all of these locations. Especially for the firemen, Father, we pray for their safety. The wind could turn in a flash and imperil their lives before they have time to move. We pray for their safety. We pray for those that are there to minister to them, the disaster relief, the American Red Cross, and others. We pray for them to be safe as well as they support. Pray for Patty, Heavenly Father, as she's in the Houston area today. We pray for the impact that she will have on the lives of others and the impact that they will have upon her as she ministers in your name to those that she comes in contact with. We pray for her safety. We pray for Wayne, Heavenly Father, as he awaits her return. Lord, as we look to the days ahead, we pray for Mike. Perhaps this will be the week that he moves. And Heavenly Father, as well, we pray for Ruby's sister and her safety, that she might celebrate that 100th birthday in just a few more months. Now, Lord, open our eyes and our ears to your word. In Jesus' name.